By the end of this video, you will learn the ultimate difference between the Figma's old UI and the new UI. You'll have easier time finding constraints, auto layout, variant, component properties, instance swap, alignments, and much more. This ultimate Figma UI 3 breakdown is covered in just 20 steps. Step 1. In the previous UI, if you decided to add and remove auto layout, all you had to do was to select your frame, navigate to the auto layout panel, and here you would see the plus and minus icon. As soon as I click plus or minus, I'm able to add and remove auto layout. In the new UI, the auto layout add and remove has changed. So if you decide to add and remove your auto layout, you have to click on that tiny icon here. In this example, I am removing my auto layout. And if I decide to add the auto layout, I would select that tiny icon to add my auto layout again. Step 2. Another major difference you see in the auto layout is the width and height section. In the new UI, as soon as you add an auto layout to a frame, you see the width and height exactly placed under your auto layout panel. For example, if you decided to increase the width to 200 pixels, you could simply do that within the auto layout panel. In the previous UI, the width and height are placed under the frame, which means if you decide to increase or decrease your width or height of your auto layout, you have to navigate to the frame section to be able to do that. Step 3. Also, another major difference is the fix, fill, and hug. These auto layout properties are no longer on the frame. They're all grouped under auto layout panel. For example, if you decide to select one of your elements, you see the option of fill, hug, and fix are placed all the way to the top next to the width and height. However, this is a major difference in the new UI. The major difference is the width and height are placed under the auto layout and fill, hug, and fix are placed as a drop down inside the width and height, which means if you select your auto layout frame, you have to click on this tiny drop down to apply fix, hug, and fill. And if you select a frame that is not an auto layout, in this example we have the text layer, which is not an auto layout frame, you see the fill, fix, and hug are placed under layout, which is not an auto layout. That is the only difference. You still have the option to click and apply fill, hug, and fix. So in the new UI, if you select a layer that is not an auto layout layer, you can modify the fill, fix, and hug using the layout panel. Also, you can modify their width and height in the same panel. Also, if you select an auto layout frame, you still have the ability to modify the fill, hug, and fix within the same auto layout panel. This is one of the major differences between the auto layout in the previous UI and the new UI, which basically separated all the width, hug, and fill properties at the top. However, in the new UI, everything is grouped under the auto layout panel. Step 4. In the previous UI, if you decided to add an absolute position in an auto layout frame, all you had to do was to navigate to the frame section, and here you see the absolute position icon. As soon as you click that, the absolute position is applied to your element. In the new UI, we don't have the frame section anymore. If you decide to add an absolute position to your element, you can find that icon in the position panel, and the absolute position icon is that tiny icon, which has been renamed to ignore auto layout. As soon as you click that, it would ignore the auto layout and it would apply absolute positioning. Step 5. In the old UI, if you decided to align your objects, in this example, let's click on the icon. Here you see the alignment panel appears on the top right. So I have the ability to align my item inside my card. However, in the new UI, the alignment panel is no longer at the top right. As you can see, it's being replaced with the instance panel, and it's actually being placed under the position panel. So here I have the ability to align my item inside my cart. Step 6. As you can see, what you notice is the rotation option in the previous UI was not placed next to the alignment. We also didn't have the ability to flip our elements. However, in the new UI, the rotation is placed next to the alignment. Now you can flip your elements vertically and horizontally if you decide to, and also rotate them every 90 degrees. Moreover, you see that the X and Y coordinates are also placed under the position. In the previous UI, the X and Y coordinates are no longer placed under the frame panel. They're all grouped under the position panel in the new UI. Step 7. Also, in the previous UI, if you select your elements and if you want to tidy them up, here you see that the icon is on the top right. You see the option of tidying up your elements. However, in the new UI, you might not see this option when you highlight your elements. This option is hidden under the three dots under the position panel. So as soon as you click that, you now have the option to click on tidy up. In the previous UI, if you decide to actually increase or decrease the space between your elements when you tidy them up, you find these options under the frame panel. However, in the new UI, they are placed under the width and height. Now you have the ability to adjust the vertical and horizontal spacing between your cards. Step 8. In the previous UI, if you decided to clip your content, you find the clip content option under the frame and you can toggle it to clip your content. In the new UI, you don't find this option again under the frame. It is being moved to the layout panel. Now you have the ability to clip your content the same way under the layout panel. Step 9. In the previous UI, if you decided to trim your frame, you could click on your card in this example and click on this icon, which is resize to fit. As soon as you click that, you would be able to trim your frame. In the new UI, if you decide to resize your frames and make them fit the content, you'll find this option under the layout panel all the way to the right side. Here we have the ability to resize our elements. Step 10. In the previous UI, if you decided to add round corners to your elements, you would select your elements. As you can see under the frame panel, panel, we have corner radius. So we can simply increase and decrease the value. And as you can see, our card is being rounded. Also, if you decided to round them individually, we could click on this tiny icon, which is independent corners. As soon as we click that, here you see we can individually round the corners. In the new UI, if you decide to add round corners to your elements, you can find that under the frame. You have to scroll down. There is another section which is called appearance. This is a new panel that is being added in the new UI. So if you decide to round your corners, you have to navigate to appearance. And then here we see the ability for us to increase the corner radius. And as you can see, as soon as we increase that, we are able to round them. And also we have the option to individually round the corners, which is placed exactly in the same area. Step 11, if you decide to hide your element, you have to visit the appearance. And in this example, let's click on our image. And then here we have the appearance panel. By navigating to the eye icon, we have the ability to hide and show our icon. Previously, this was not placed here. So in the previous UI, if you decided to hide and show your elements, you had to scroll all the way to the layer section, which is now renamed to appearance. And then here you see the hide and show icon here. Step 12. Also, if you decided to add layer effects to your Figma elements, in the new UI, you have the ability to add them within the same position. Here, if you hover over the blend mode, which is next to the hide and show icon, we have the ability to add our layer effects. In the previous UI, you had to visit the layer, and then here we have the ability to add effects this way. Moreover, the opacity of your layers is also placed next to the hide icon and also the blend mode under the layers. In the new UI, the opacity is also placed under the appearance. However, it's no longer placed under blend mode and height. It's actually placed on the left side next to the corner radius. So if you decide to increase or decrease your opacity, you have to click on the opacity icon under appearance in the new UI. Step 13. Moreover, as soon as you apply absolute positioning, you notice that the constraint panel appears right underneath. If you don't see the constraint panel, you can click and toggle the constraint panel. Constraint panel only applies if you have elements in absolute positioning, which don't respect auto layout. However, in the previous UI, we had a dedicated constraint panel. As soon as you select your elements and you ignore them using the absolute positioning, you have a dedicated constraint panel. So the only difference is the constraint panel is now pushed to the position panel. And now you can toggle it using this tiny icon, which is called constraint. And as soon as you click that, you would be able to use the constraints within your Figma element. I also have to point out that you won't be able to see the constraint because your element is not being ignored on the auto layout. So you have to make sure to click the absolute positioning to ignore the auto layout. And as soon as you do that, you have the ability to toggle the constraint. Step 14. In the previous UI, when you wanted to create a component, you had to select the frame and click on the component icon at the top. However, in the new UI, the component icon has moved to the top right. So if you decide to create a component, you have to select your frame and hover over the create component icon at the top right. Step 15. In the previous UI, if you decided to swap your instances, you can select your instance and navigate to the right side. Here you see a dropdown and you can select that. And this way you have the ability to swap your instances using the swap instance panel. In the new UI, if you decide to swap your instances, you have to click your instance and navigate to the top right. Here you see the instance name and you can click on this dropdown and you have the ability to swap your instances using the dropdown at the top. Step 16. In the previous Figma UI, if you wanted to select an instance, in this example, let's select the instance card. And if you wanted to go back to the master component, you can again simply hover over the component properties and then you see this go to the main component icon. As soon as I click that, I am brought back to the master component. Here I can click return to the instance and this way I had the ability to switch between master component and instances. However, in the new Figma UI, if you do decide to visit the master component, you no longer see that icon here. You see this icon exactly on the top right, the same way we added our variant, and the shape of the icon is different. As you can see, we are able to see local instances and the icon is changed. So here I can click on that and this would bring me back to the main component. So here I can click on return to the instance. This way I'm able to navigate back to the master component using this local instance button. Step 17. In the previous UI Figma, if you wanted to add variant, you had to simply hover over the top icon. And as you can see, we have the ability to add variant. As soon as we click the plus, you see another variant is added for us. And then on the right side, the component property panel is updated. However, in the new Figma UI, if you click on your component, and if you do want to add a variant, you see that the plus icon is no longer available at top. You can find this plus icon all the way to the top right. As soon as I select my component, I have the ability to add a variant. And here you see the plus icon is available next to the three dots. So I can simply click that and another variant is added for me. Step 18. In the previous UI, if you tried to create a variant, you had to click on your component. And as you can see on the top right, there is no variant section. So you had to scroll down to get to the property section, and then here we have the plus. And then as soon as we click the plus, we have the option to choose between variant, boolean, instant swap, and text. However, after the Figma's new update, if you click on your variant set, you no longer see that property panel here. The whole property panel is completely moved to the top. Moreover, if you highlight over the properties here, you'd be able to see the plus button. Simply, if I hover over that, you see I no longer see the plus button, so I have to hover over the properties. This way I'm able to see the plus. And now if I click that, you see I have the option to choose between variant, boolean, instant swap, and text. Step 19. If you wanted to change the name of your component, you had multiple ways to do that. Simply by double clicking and changing the name here to, for example, card 2. You also had the ability to change the name of the master component using, again, the layer panel. Here, let's change it to card 3. Also, you had the ability to change the name of the component on the right side here. You see we have card 3, we can change it to card 4. Any of these areas that you change the name of the component, it gets reflected everywhere. In the new Figma UI, you have the same ability to change the name of the component using the layers, also by double clicking on the component. However, if you do decide to change the name of your component using the component properties, you notice that it is being moved to the top. You can simply hover over to the top and change the name of your component that way. This is one of the differences between the previous UI and the new UI. As soon as you change the name of the component in the component's property panel, the name of your component is changed on the layer side and as well as the canvas. In the previous UI, if you wanted to find where your Figma file is, you could have navigated to the top, and then as you can see, the parent Figma file was placed to the left side. In the new Figma UI, the parent file is placed at the bottom. Also, if you decide to rename your files, you no longer can do it from the top. You have to click at the top left and rename your files here. Step 20. In the previous UI, if you decided to change the name of your properties, you had to visit the properties panel. And then as you can see, you see this edit icon. So you can click the edit icon to rename your property. If I click on my property, I'm not able to rename them unless I double click to rename each of them. In Figma UI 3, you can simply click on your component. And as you can see, the properties appear on the top right side. You no longer need to click on edit to edit the name of your property. You can simply click once in each of them and you're able to edit them using single click. So if you decide to actually reorder them, you have to hover over that tiny icon on the left side, then you'd be able to reorder them. However, in the previous UI, you could have simply clicked and reordered them without actually worrying about hovering over the tiny icon. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more design tips and tutorials, and let me know what you think in the comments down below.